Hey, robot fans, and hey, fish fans. Yes, I am a huge fan of the band Phish. I've been seeing them for many, many years. This New Year's Eve was the seventh consecutive New Year's Eve Phish extravaganza for me and Mrs. Patchbots. The cool thing about seeing Phish at New Year's Eve is that they always do a stunt or a gag to do the countdown at midnight. This year it was a pirate-themed countdown, and the entire audience was wearing these Xylobands. This created a really cool lighting effect, and the Xylobands stayed lit through the night, past the show, all the way until I went to bed, but sure enough, when I woke up, it was dead. So today we are going to try to revive one of these Xylobands and see if we can make something fun out of it. So diving right in, the back of the wristband is secured with four screws. You can take those right off, and you're instantly greeted with the battery pack. These are 3-volt batteries. There is a pair wired in series to give you 6 volts, and another single battery staying at 3 volts. These are mounted to a PCB, which are attached with a couple plastic clips, and that slides right out. The main face of the wristband has 4 NeoPixel lights, which is pretty much what I figured, and those are attached to a single hub at the top of the main board, and the wristband lights are attached to 2 hubs going off of the side of the board. Okay, here's the main terminal for the NeoPixels. There's 4 pins here, labeled 1 through 4. If we trace off the fourth one, we could see that it's a path on the PCB that travels down here. It goes to this guy here, which is R4. R4 is going to be a resistor, and then after R4, it goes to this power source, which is, if we flip this back over, it's the positive terminal of SKT4, which is the 6-volt terminal. So I know that there were 6 volts going into the NeoPixels. These other 3 pins are your R, G, and B for your red, green, and blue of the NeoPixels. And mixing up those terminals is how you get all of your colors. The first thing I did was get rid of those battery terminals. The batteries are probably dead, and I don't plan on using the terminals anyway, so I just hacked those right off. Next, I soldered a ground and a positive wire to the old battery terminal and got this all set up. Okay, so we have power going to the back of the wristband here from a dedicated DC power supply at 6 volts. That's going to replicate that battery series that we had at the back. Now all we need to do is short out these pins to see the colors. So I have an alligator clip attached to a ground pin at the corner of the board here, and the end of the wire is here. So if I start touching this to the pins, we should see color. That pin 1 is blue. Pin 2 is red, and pin 3 is green. So cool, that works. The wristband works, and now we just need to figure out a better way to wire this thing so that we can get to those pins a little bit easier than touching them with the end of an alligator clip.
I went online searching for a schematic, and I hit pay dirt. There was an instructable from a guy who hacked his Xyloband after a Coldplay show. He has schematics, wiring diagrams, and even some sample Arduino code to run. So this is perfect. This will save some time.
I went through the page and I soldered the wires to the proper pads that represent the RGB colors on the board. I got it all wired into the Arduino, and I am currently running the sample code from the Instructables page. It basically just runs through all of the colors, both the primary and the secondary colors, to show that the NeoPixels are working properly, which they are. So on the hardware side of things, I think we're good.
I drilled a hole in the back of the wristband to route the wires through after I reassembled them. I slipped the PCB back into its little plastic clips and screwed it all back together. Just for good measure, I did the same thing with Mrs. Patchbot's wristband, and now I have the two synced up, running off of the same software and the same hardware. Now it's time to figure out how we're going to display these wristbands. Part of the pirate theme of New Year's Eve was a fish-themed pirate flag. I think I'm going to try to use this as my main design element. I'm going to build this out as a type of box with all the electronics inside and a switch, and then on the top face of the box I'm going to have a 3D printed pirate fish logo, as well as the wristbands mounted and flashing. Phish actually just posted a replica flag on their dry goods site, so this is a perfect image for me to use as reference. I downloaded the image and traced it out in Illustrator to get it into vector form. From there, I imported it into my 3D program and extruded it. This gives me a nice 3D model to size and ultimately print. Printing all these pieces is going to take some time, but luckily a big brown box has just arrived from Amazon. In the box are 3 black ABS plastic sheets, 12 inches by 24 inches, which in addition to making a really cool sound, are also perfect for constructing the outside of the box.
I've also printed out some corner pieces here using some purple filament since it's not going to be seen, and a special corner piece that's going to house the switch which will turn everything on.
The first thing I do is cut down the 24-inch ABS sheet to about 20 inches, which will be the final size of the flag box. I also want to cut out the slots for the wristbands. I made these little wristband holders which will slide into the slot and cover all the rough edges from the cut. With both slots cut, I test fitted the wristbands in their holders to make sure they fit nice and snug, which they did. I also printed a little protoboard holder. I'm going to use one of these little prototype boards as our main control panel, so that will be held near the center on the back. Using the switch corner, the board holder, and one of the regular corners, I glued together one solid side of the frame. From there I can start fitting the main faceplate. I'm going to attach it with a little bit of an inset edge. As it turns out, the 24 inch by 12 inch boards that I bought from Amazon were actually 23.75 by 11.75, so I'm going to try to make up that distance with the binding. I glue the first main wall onto the faceplate and clamp it down to dry. Whoever invented CLA Accelerator deserves some kind of award because this whole process went really quickly. I got all the printed corner pieces attached in no time and was able to also attach all the ABS sides in one evening and let it cure overnight. In the morning I had a nice sturdy box. It looks a little crappy around the edges, but that's where the binding is going to come in. I printed a 1/2 inch white binding similar to the white hem on the pirate flag and attached it all around. Now we can start installing the electronics into the box. The first thing I did was put some felt tape onto my wristband holders to make them look a little nicer, and I glued those into place.
Next up is building the circuit board. The circuit board is going to consist of just a few components. We have the Arduino Nano here, which is going to run our code. We have a voltage converter, which is going to step down the 9 volts from the wall down to 5 volts for the NeoPixels. I'm using 3 NPN transistors. These are TIP 120 style, which is probably a bit overkill, but it's just what I have on hand. And then I have some input pins just to make everything look nice and neat.
Okay, I wired the board together and installed it onto the back of the sign. I got the wristbands wired into the proper transistors, and I even installed a barrel jack onto the switch, which will accept the adapter from the wall and give us our power. With everything done here, we can give it our first real test. I have some code running that's just playing each color one at a time to see that everything is wired correctly, which it is. So now that the structure is sound and the electronics are done, all that's left to do is add our Phish Pirate logo. Assembly goes how you think it would go, just gluing all these little pieces, the fish logo, the bones, and all the individual little bubbles onto the front of the ABS panel. When this is done, I let it cure overnight, and then we're basically finished. I updated the code on the Arduino to fade in between the colors. I'm going to hang this on my wall, maybe turn it on during couch tour or when I'm doing something else fish related. Thanks for tuning into the video. If you liked what you saw, you can click this button here to subscribe. Also, check out some of my other robotics builds here on the channel. You can check out my Instagram account where I post pictures fairly often, way more often than I post videos. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and whatever you do, take care of your shoes.